Hello and welcome back to Proactive New York. Joining me this afternoon is Matthew Pierce, CEO at Versus Systems. Matthew, it's great to see you again. How are you?
I'm doing well. It's always good to see you, Christine. How are you?
I'm good. Thanks for asking. Lots to get to today. First off, you did close that public offering of $7 million in gross proceeds. Tell us more about what you've been up to in the last few months.
I think this is really an opportunity for us to sort of reestablish who we are and where we're going. This new infusion of capital led by some of the folks that we're going to be talking about later is, it's an opportunity for us to bring rewards and engagement to new verticals. It's an opportunity for us to take that capital and really scale kind of where we're going. At our core, we're kind of an engagement and rewards company and always have been. And we make all the content that we touch more engaging with interactivity and rewards. And so the proceeds of this raise are really meant to help us to grow in a couple of different areas, really kind of four KPIs that we're going to talk about, not just with this press release, but with sort of all other press releases so that we can contextualize those a little bit. Whenever we're talking about stuff that we're doing, we're relating it to one of these KPIs. One is just the pure number of contracts that we've got out in the world. So obviously, we were able to work with a bunch of NFL teams last year, which culminated in the Super Bowl, where both of the participants, the Bengals and the Rams, were both Versus clients. So we did work for both of those teams throughout the season. Now we have NASCAR. We've got a bunch of NCAA basketball teams playing. We've got, NHL. We've got 50 or so different activations every week, which are all available on the activations calendar at Versus. That's one area, is just pure contracts. And then the next is sort of making sure that every contract is as valuable as it can be, sort of working on the average value per contract. And part of that is adding scalable elements, making them longer term or higher volume contracts, which is to say that they have more events inside of them. Scalable elements here include things like cost per click or cost per engagement, where we're working with advertisers to add additional value to the engagement by the introduction of prizes. Average number of contracts, average value per contract, and then working with more and more advertisers that are participating in the system. For example, currently we're working with an agency called Ent, which is working with Slim Chickens, which is a restaurant in the United States that has an opportunity right now to win a catered Final Four party. The QR code appears on the cups, so you can actually just come into the restaurant, sit down, and take a picture. You play a basketball game, obviously during March Madness, play a basketball game, and you can win coupons, you can win discounts, and the grand prize winner is going to win a big, huge catered Final Four party, which is cool, right? The opportunity here to work with QSRs, to work with agencies, to work with people to make their real experiences more fun when they're playing games. So, number of contracts, average value per contract, the number of advertisers in the system, and then the final one, which is what we're here to talk about today, is sort of new verticals for the prizing and the engagement platforms that we've built. The new verticals here really include a wide variety of things. So not just sports. We've done a lot of in-venue work, obviously, of those 50 engagements that we're doing every week. A huge percentage of them are in traditional sports, right? They're in NFL, they're in NCAA basketball, they're in NBA basketball, they're in NHL, this type of thing. And so now starting to talk about being able to go into new verticals, non-sports verticals, growing areas, even being able to do in-venue inside of Slim Chickens, inside of that restaurant, which is such a great activation for us and for them. I think they're really, fans like being able to win stuff while they're at lunch. And so Animoca, who we're really very excited to partner with in this last round, we've been partnered with them for some time, but the idea that they really wanted to infuse some capital into this last round and really work with us to grow, watch to earn, play to earn, and add different kinds of rewards into our rewards ecosystem really speaks well of the work that we've been up to and, the opportunities that we have going forward.
They are a blockchain gaming company, definitely a new vertical here. So yeah, tell us a bit more how you'll work together.
Well, they've had tremendous success, certainly in the last 18 months, with the growth of a wide variety of blockchain games, being able to play to win, which is an important part of sort of how they're thinking about the world. They're doing a lot of decentralized finance work. They're doing a lot of Web3 work. They're doing a lot of metaverse work that's going to give people an opportunity to win, you know, digital goods that have value in the real world. And the largest number of prizes that we've ever given out historically has been digital goods. We've been in the digital goods space for years, including the work that we did with NASCAR years ago around being able to just play NASCAR Heat Mobile and win gas and win different things inside the game that were valuable inside the game. So this idea of bringing digital rewards to people that want to win them is something that we've been doing for a long time, but Animoca really took it to a different level. The amount of money that they've been able to raise in the last year, something on the tune of $500 million at around a $5 billion valuation, and the people that they got the money from, it's indicative of the idea that Web3 is gonna be a really, really powerful force going forward. And the work that Yat Siu, who's the chairman of Animoca, and his team have been able to, the successes that they've had in the last couple of years really speak to how long they laid the groundwork for Web3 or how much work they did. And, you know, they're in all kinds of, you know, Dapper Labs and OpenSea and Kraken and a bunch of others where blockchain has really been at the fore, and that they're investing in us as well, I think suggests that they think that there's a bright future in engagement and rewards across a huge number of prize types and reward types, including blockchain rewards.
Do you see yourselves partnering with more of these types of companies of blockchain and Web3?
I think so. I mean, the idea that we've always had is that rewards, interactivity and rewards make content more engaging and more fun. People want to win things while they're watching TV or while they're listening to podcasts or while they're playing video games. They want their time to be seen as valuable, right? They want that attention to be seen as valuable. And rather than having their private information sold, I think they would rather be, you know, compensated for their time and their energy and their effort. And I think that they would rather earn prizes than, you know, than be forced to watch commercials that they don't want to watch, for example. I think that the idea of the agency of the end user, the agency of the viewer, the player, it really matters. And I think that we're changing some models, not so radically as they've never been seen before. Obviously, you know, Nielsen did tremendous work, you know, and still continues to do tremendous work around making sure that they are compensating people for their time, learning more about what they watch, learning more about what they consume. You know, companies that have done work around making sure that content providers can be compensated for their work. Here, I'm thinking about companies like Patreon, who do a great job of making sure that content providers can be compensated by their fans. There's just a lot of opportunities here for unlocking play to earn, watch to earn, and adding rewarded elements into content that we've been working on for years. We have a bunch of patents around how to do it, how to do it at scale. But the idea that we can take a new category of rewards, blockchain and blockchain elements, it's less about the cryptocurrency. It's more about, is this a reward that people want? Right? Is this a prize that people want? And people have won, you know, experiences and apparel and food and beverage and, you know, coupons and, you know, airline miles and all sorts of things like that, gift cards in our system, and have been doing so for years. The idea that we can add blockchain pricing into the system is a natural extension of what we're doing. And people are excited about being able to win stuff that they care about. And it turns out that there's a whole group of people that care about, you know, blockchain pricing. So we're very excited at it.
That's good to hear. All right. Looking forward to following progress here. Matt, thanks a lot.
Thank you, Christine. Take care.